Welcome to this historic event. On behalf of the Investiture Committee and the Board of Trustees, it is with great pride that I extend the warmest greetings to all of you. This momentous occasion heralds a new era in the history of Baliuag University. A time for new hopes and new aspirations, new dreams and new possibilities. In this ceremonial gathering, we shall solemnize the investiture of Dr. Patricia Lagunda, the second president of Baliuag University. This occasion is also a time to reflect on the vision of our predecessors, to reaffirm our commitment to academic excellence, and to uphold the core values of responsibility, integrity, service, excellence, and respect. For as Aristotle once said, educating the mind without educating the heart is no education at all. Thank you and welcome once again to Baliuag University.
Panginoon aming Ama, pinasasalamatan namin ang pagkakatong ito ng pagtatalaga ng ikalawang pangulo ng pamantasang Baliuag. Dalangin naming lahat na matiwasay na maidaos ang pagtatalagang ito at sumaamin nawa ang baspas ng aming mahal na pangulo sa mga kawaninang pamantasang Baliuag, sa mga naritong mga panauhin at ang pagtatagumpay ng aming mahal na pamantasan sa kanyang adhikain sa lipunan at pamayanan.
Lord, our Father, our source of wisdom and grace, we are grateful for all the goodness and kindness you've been generously bestowing upon each one of us and upon Baliuag University for the past 9 glorious decades. The triumph and recognition that our beloved institution had achieved and the difficulties that had been overcome are undeniable manifestations of your presence and guidance. As this day signifies another milestone for Baliuag University, may we remain steadfast in carrying out our mission and vision to bring to our stakeholders, most especially to our students, the best learning experience possible.
Lord, our Father, we are very thankful for all the gifts you have given us. We thank you for providing us with our needs and for sending us your angels in heaven in the person of our parents, relatives, friends, and teachers who constantly support and guide us in our everyday life. With another new angel now, our President, Dr. Patricia Lagunda, the blessing of your presence will continue to shine upon us. Grant her the will and strength to always keep Baliuag University as a safe shelter for us to learn and enjoy life.
Lord, our Father, we thank you for always being the great provider of knowledge and experience. We pray that we would be able to honor you in our profession and that we would be able to emulate the core values of Baliuag University: responsibility, integrity, service, excellence, and respect, as we carry out our respective duties and functions efficiently and effectively. Help us all to be able to model and inspire employees, that we will be able to encourage and support each other. May the quality of our work and our faithfulness be a testimony that brings honors to you.
Mahal naming Diyos Ama, pinasasalamatan namin ang aming pagiging bahagi sa mahalagang okasyon ito. Kinikilala namin ang iyong kapangyarihan at pag-ibig na ibubuhos sa okasyon ito. Sa pagtatapos ng pagtatalagang ito, ikaw ang tunay na gabay sa lahat. Ang aming gawain sa pamantasan, ang aming gawain sa darating na panahon. Kakasihan mo kami at ang aming mga gawain tungo sa pagtatagumpay. Nang lahat ng narito, mag-aaral, kawani, at administrador, sa iyo po ang papuri.
Lord, our Father, we offer you our gratitude for the bountiful gift of wisdom, which brings clarity to our hearts and minds as we direct our students to the meaningful pathway of learning. Now, with this another milestone in the history of Baliuag University, the installation of our new president, Dr. Patricia B. Lagunda, the light you have casted on the pavement of learning becomes more defined and radiant. Help us to see the potential in each student, and may we be able to recognize the gifts and talents that you have placed within each student who will be the shining ensemble of this institution's radiant future.
Lord, our Father, we send to you our deepest gratitude for giving us the opportunity to take part in today's important event. We pray that the guidance of our new president, Dr. Patricia B. Lagunda, will further encourage and strengthen our spirit, soul, and body, that we will have the discernment and wisdom concerning the choices that we will make. We ask that our new president be your instrument in revealing the plans and purposes that you have for us. Please give us the courage and boldness to pursue our God-given destiny, wisdom, and insight to develop the gifts and talents you have placed within us.
Pinasasalamatan ka namin, O aming Ama, dahil sa iyong banal na espiritu at sa iyong mga salita. Papuri ay para sa iyo sa pagkakaroon ng okasyong tulad nito, ang investidura ni Dr. Patricia B. Lagunda bilang pangalawang pangulo ng pamantasang Baliuag. Gabayan mo ang aming pagdiriwang na ito. Mamayani ang iyong dakilang kamay na siyang gagabay sa panahong ito. Gayon din, dalangin namin na maging sa mga hinaharap kung saan maglalakbay ang pamantasang Baliuag para sa edukasyon, ay makamit nito ang inilatag na bisyon, misyon at mga layunin. Dahil sa gabay mo at matalinong pangunguna ng aming mahal na pangunahing administrador.
Lord our Father, we humbly come before you to acknowledge all the many blessings we have received for being able to witness this momentous occasion. All our success comes from you. Thank you for the countless favors you have showered on Baliuag University. As the university installs its new president, Dr. Patricia B. Lagunda, loving Father, in gratitude, allow us to consecrate Baliuag University to your loving heart. We consecrate to you our stakeholders and partners, that they may be guided by your will in their decisions. We consecrate to you our officers. May they continue to faithfully serve you as they carry out our school's mission, vision, and goals. We consecrate to you all our employees as well as their families. May we all continue to do our best as we go about our work and commit ourselves to the betterment of our university, our community, and our country. We consecrate to you our students and public. May they continue to recognize and appreciate all our efforts and the services we offer. All these we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
The glorious past, radiant future, marks the celebration of the 90th year of Baliuag University, and today, the tribute to the first university president and the investiture of the second university president highlight this event. A beautiful morning and a warm welcome to all. We have witnessed the colorful pageantry of today's processional, as well as the moving rendition of our talented students and the hospitality shown by our BU community. Baliuag University is truly proud of them. We are deeply honored with your presence, sharing your most precious time. Gracing this occasion is more than a gift to us. We would like to recognize the presence of our distinguished guests from the House of Representatives, from the Commission on Higher Education, from the Department of Education, from the Technical Skills Development Agency, officials from the province of Bulacan and municipality of Baliuag and nearby provinces and neighboring cities and municipalities, presidents of different colleges and universities, officers of professional associations, social civic organizations, and we are blessed too with the presence of some religious orders with us. We would like to recognize the participation of the members of our own faculty, the personnel, administrative officers, and the board of trustees. Of course, we are delighted by the presence of the university alumni, family, and relatives of our dear president. To our academic marshals and color cadets, thank you for leading and guiding the processional this morning. Finally, a very special welcome
to the individuals who are at the heart of our commitment to quality education, the students of academic institutions. This is a jubilant and unprecedented episode in the life of Baliuag University, and we are most grateful to all of you for being a part of us in today's celebration. Again, on behalf of us all, we are deeply appreciative and we offer you our most grateful welcome. Welcome to Baliuag University. Magandang umaga at maligayang pagdating.
Dr. Patricia Biliquan, Chairman of the Commission on Higher Education, Dr. Patricia Bustos Lagunda. Ladies and gentlemen, fellow presidents of academic schools, friends and relatives of the celebrant, as well as students and members of the faculty. I first came to know Dr. Alicia Santiago Bustos, Alice, as her friends call her, many years ago, sometime in 1976. I was a member of PACU at the time, and I remember Alice, who for the longest time was chairman of the PACOCOA, or the Philippine Association of Colleges and Universities Committee or Commission on Accreditation. Because of the length of time and the number of schools that she has visited and accredited, we came to call her as the mother of accreditation. Well, Alice had the charge to accredit the programs of higher education institutions who desire to meet the standards of quality over and above the minimum required for government recognition. Her classification of HEI programs into levels 1, 2, 3, and 4 were always beyond question. I also remember Alice as president of PACU from 1996 to 1998. I remember her especially for three things. First, during her term as president, I remember PACU as instrumental in the promulgation of Dole-Deck's TED Tesla Order No. 1 and Dole-Deck's TED Tesla Order No. 2, which were then both signed by Angel C. Alcala, then chairman of CHED, Ricardo T. Gloria, then secretary of DECS, Leonardo Gisumbing, then secretary of Dole, and Jose D. Lacson, then director general of TESDA. Dole-Deck's CHED TESDA Order No. 1 provides, among others, in no uncertain terms, the probationary period of teaching or academic personnel, that only full-time teaching or academic personnel who possess the enumerated qualifications can acquire regular status, and that part-timers cannot acquire tenure. Dole-Deck's CHED TESDA Order No. 2, on the other hand, provide, among others, that overloads partake of the nature of temporary extra assignment and compensation, therefore, shall be considered as honorarium and does not form part of basic pay. Second, during Alice's presidency of PACU, together with other COCOPEA members, suspended classes for one day in protest over the approval on second reading of the proposed Magna Carta for students in the House of Representatives. You see, Alice is also an activist of some sort. Up to now, this Magna Carta is still languishing in the House and is being resurrected by politicians to court the student votes during elections. Third, it was Alice who gave Paco a home, where its headquarters is now located at Unit 601, Richmond Plaza Corner, San Miguel Avenue and Lourdes Drive, or Tigas Center, Pasig City. Were it not for Alice, Paco would still be renting a small room at Isabel Building in Hispania, Manila. Thank you, Alice, for everything. You will never be forgotten. Thank you.
Great ambition and conquest without contribution is without significance. What will your contribution be? How will history remember you? This is a famous line from the movie The Emperor's Club, uttered by a great teacher, William Hundred, to his students. The path to greatness has been laid for our president. So far, she has conquered it with sheer grace and much passion. Her contributions have already been etched in Baliuag University through the initiatives and reforms she advocated as the vice president and executive vice president. Now, stepping in as the president of this university and continuing on with the legacy set forth by its founder, Tatang, is the primary task on hand. The responsibility to continue providing the young minds of Baliuag and neighboring towns with premier quality education. The past 9 decades have laid out the beautiful story of Baliuag University, both the songs of struggles and the tales of triumph. In the coming years, the same songs and more tales may be written or heard again, but her leadership will guide us through in weaving our own contributions to this institution. Certainly, one of the defining qualities of her leadership will be her proactive sense of responsibility, being perceptive of the dynamic realm of education, and being mindful of the needs of all the stakeholders. As such, the faculty members, personnel, students, and the entire BU community take pride in recognizing Dr. Patricia Bustos Lagunda as the second president of Baliuag University. Whatever the future holds for Baliuag University, it will surely be radiant as she provides us with a clear vision of what we want to achieve for our beloved institution. That future will also be one day part of a glorious past.
In its 90th year of existence, Baliuag University has been continuously recognized in the region as an institution that emulates best practices in education. The quality of instruction always reflects adherence beyond the standards set forth by governing bodies, thus providing the learners of Baliuag and neighboring towns efficient and effective services they deserve. In this modern day, survival for many educational institutions has become more challenging. So quality comes at a high stake. Baliuag University vows to remain competitive but still rooted in moral and ethical standards. The leadership of the new president of Baliuag University, Dr. Patricia Bustos Lagunda, will certainly continue to uphold the values instilled by her predecessors as she further brings this university to greater heights. As she is inspired by the founding leaders of this university before her, she in return will inspire the faculty members, personnel, students, and alumni to advocate humanitarian values and community diversity as they fulfill their roles in the university. Delivering their duties will always be guided by honest dealings and genuine concern for the welfare of the community they serve.
Through the years, Baliuag University has been serious in serving the populace by relentlessly initiating, supporting, and offering different programs in the community. In its 90 years of existence, Baliuag University has been sensitive to the call of the community for a quality and yet affordable education from kindergarten to graduate studies. From the introduction of its then first to two-year college courses, namely Junior Normal Course and Liberal Arts Course in 1947, this academic institution is offering more than 20 undergraduate and graduate programs as of date, which are mostly accredited by several accrediting agencies such as Philippine Association of Colleges and University Commission on Accreditation, or PACUCOA. The name Baliuag University, or BU, does not only carry the mark of quality education. In the spirit of service, the university also provides a scholarship to 24% of its studentry, giving opportunity to deserving but less fortunate students who cannot afford quality education. Furthermore, it has been known by the nearby communities for its community extension programs, such as the BU Hatilingap sa Nangangailangan or Halina, which aims to reach out to the needy and be of service to the whole community, all of which were started by Dr. Alicia Santiago Bustos and continued by enabling leadership of Dr. Patricia Lagunda. The new university president, as well as his alumni, who has drawn inspiration from the kind of leadership and service known by her predecessors.
Baliuag University excels in its essence as a prime mover of quality education, not just in the province of Bulacan, but in the whole region, the Central Luzon region. As a university with autonomous status granted by the Commission on Higher Education, or CHED, for 14 years now, BU has proven time and again that the holistic education it offers to its clientele is aligned with national and international standards. In its continued pursuit of excellence, Baliuag University, through the committed leadership of the new university president, Dr. Alicia, Dr. Patricia Lagunda, has established international linkages with several academic institutions in ASEAN countries to expose the students to the different practices and prepare them for the ASEAN integration. Through the passion and determination of the president and the unwavering support of the administrators, teaching and non-teaching personnel of Baliuag University, BU has attained the stature as one of the best universities in Central Luzon region and in the Philippines.
As a place where great minds meet and are further nourished, Baliuag University has maintained its position in respecting the intellect of different individuals who come from different personal and cultural backgrounds, students, faculty members, and non-teaching staff, regardless of their ideologies and beliefs, are welcome to exhibit and share their talents, skills, and knowledge with the whole academic community. Through the able leadership of the past president and now chairperson, Dr. Alicia Santiago Bustos, the university has become a home where intellectuals agree to disagree and accept to oppose. This is the legacy that Dr. Patricia Lagunda, the new university president, wishes to continue, for she wants the institution to be a nurturing place for talented individuals and to be a learning environment that respects and values differences.
Our chairman of the Commission on Higher Education, Dr. Patricia Licuana. And of course, our president of Baliuag University, Dr. Patricia Bustos Lagunda. Members of the Baliuag University community and colleagues of academic institutions and friends, family, and all of us who are here, happy to see and be with Dr. Patricia Lagunda during her installation. Good morning. I am honored to join you today for the installation of Dr. Patricia Lagunda, my colleague and friend, as the second president of Baliuag University. I send greetings from the Philippine Association of Colleges and Universities and the Private Education Retirement Annuity Association, PERAA, and of course, the Misamis University. I have known Pat for a very long time now. That was when my father, the late Nestor Feliciano, used to ask me to accompany him to attend the PACU meetings. During that time, the other presidents of member institutions also had the same idea as my father to expose their children to PACU early. And through this meeting, I was privileged to have met Pat and her sisters. When Dr. Alice Bustos, Tita Alice, became president of PACU, my father was her first vice president, and he succeeded Tita Alice as president. It was therefore more than a coincidence, maybe fate, that we followed in their footsteps. So when Pat was president of PACU, I was her first vice president and eventually succeeded her as PACU president. And as I worked with Pat, I was able to know her not only professionally, but also personally. As a colleague, she has shown very commendable work ethics, which has allowed PACU to be a very dynamic organization. Her tenacity and diplomacy have made not only PACU, but also COCOPEA during her term as chairman, truly a collegial body. Her ability to pay attention to the smallest details have made our activities very successful. And as a friend, she has shown kindness and support, which have made our times after our professional responsibilities also pleasurable and fulfilling. With all these traits and her academic achievements, Baliuag University will surely be ready to hurdle the next challenges ahead and achieve more. Congratulations, President Patricia Bustos Lagunda. I pray that the good Lord will continue to shower you with His blessings as you embark on this new journey with immense responsibilities. And with the love and support of your family and the cooperation of the entire Baliuag University community, it will be a very rewarding journey for you. Best of luck, my friend, my colleague, and congratulations again. God bless.
Good morning to our CHED chairperson, Dr. Patricia Licuanan. I remembered your name. To our representatives of our local government units, our esteemed Mayor Carol De Llosa, to representatives of the Senate and the Congress, to representatives of TESTA, to representatives of other government agencies here today, to the heads of the various institutes of higher education, the HEIs, who are here today to honor Dr. Lagunda, to members of the board of the various accrediting agencies, to Dr. Alice S. Bustos, the chairperson of the Board of Trustees of Baliuag University, to the members of the board, to the members of the Lagunda family who are here, to the members of the Bustos and the Santiago families, to Baliuag University, its administration and staff, and the students, most especially the students, the faculty, to other guests and friends who I failed to recognize. Good morning. Good morning. That ends my speech. Dr. Patricia Bustos Lagunda, where is she? There she is. This solemn ceremony symbolizes the installation of your good self as the authority to guide Baliuag University, one of the Philippines' oldest autonomous universities, through the currents of change that now batter the shores of education. Today, you become the captain of this vessel of knowledge on which tens of thousands of passengers in the form of employees, students, alumni, and industry partners hang on to your every word, action, and gesture as signposts of salvation, debating their meanings and intentions as the good ship Baliuag University, now your BU, goes through the rapids of senior high school, outcomes-based education, and regional integration. Those who have gone before you know this responsibility is not to be taken lightly.
Allow me, therefore, on behalf of the university and college presidents present, to offer you our heartfelt condolences on your inauguration as the second president of Baliuag University. Levity aside, as most of you know by now, Baliuag University began in 1925 as Baliuag Institute. Let me repeat then what has become conventional wisdom, so I don't spend too much time on it. Baliuag University, in case there is any doubt, is a great institution and deserving of its reputation. It is an institution that students aspire to enter. It has been true to its vision of producing graduates who have contributed to the advancement of education in the Philippines. It has produced tycoons, technocrats, finance wizards, acclaimed nurses and educators, communicators, and people of science in all fields of expertise. All of this did not happen by chance. These happened because of the quality of the people in front of me, the faculty, the staff, its alumni, and most importantly, its graduates, those of you here before me. So before I continue, I wish to congratulate all of you. Though this is a celebration of Dr. Lagunda and about Baliuag University, I cannot help, similar to Karen, but reflect on the similarities between our institution and BU. We were founded within a few years of each other just after World War I, both starting as institutes. After 70 years, we became universities within just a year of each other. Dr. Alice S. Bustos, the chairperson of BU and a pillar in Philippine education, Dr. Armand V. Fabella, and Dr. Jose D. Baltasar from our institution would meet frequently to compare notes and do this for over 3 decades. Today, Pat and I, as I call her, sit on at least 3 education boards together. That means, on average, that I get to see Pat at least twice a month, far more than I see my sister, my aunts and uncles, and definitely my barber. So the conversation about education continues between our institutions today. And throughout the years, JRU has adopted many of Baliuag's innovations, whether it be in pedagogy, partnerships, or purchasing. And for that, allow me, on behalf of our university, to thank Baliuag University for all the help it has given us. But it's not about us, it's about Dr. Lagunda. So what would you like to know about Pat that hasn't already been said? So this is the part where we get to embarrass her. Aside from her achievements at BU, she was the immediate past chairperson of COCOPEA. For those of you who don't know what that is, that's the Coordinating Council of Private Educational Associations, and the immediate past president of the Philippine Association of Colleges and Universities. As Karen mentioned, through these, she has governed close to over 1,000 heads of colleges, schools, and universities. She furthermore sits on the Education and Finance Committees of PERAA, which is a $6.5 billion retirement fund for teachers. So in addition to running Baliuag University, there's a lot of other stuff that Pat does. And all this other stuff, she doesn't get paid for. Her academic credentials are excellent. She earned her PhD, I understand with distinction, in educational leadership and management from a small school in Taft Avenue. She obtained her MBA from AIM, which is acknowledged to be one of the best management schools in Asia. And she was a university scholar and a dean's lister from an equally small school, this time in Diliman, where she took up her Bachelor of Arts in Economics. But more than public accolades, let me tell you about Pat the person. I'll get out the stuff that's not in my speech first. Those of you who have had the opportunity to be with her, 3 things. First is she likes food, right? Second is, though she will not mention it, she will actually deny it, if you put a microphone in front of her, she will sing and not stop singing. And thirdly, and the one that came to me as a surprise, is that He is very fond of massages. So that's a tidbit for all of you. Whenever she travels, unlike the rest of us who ache to meet heads of other universities, Pat will look for the spa beside the hotel. But more than the public accolades and these jokes, I think Pat, the Pat Lagunda you need to know is Pat Lagunda, the nurturer. Pat Lagunda, the mother. Anyone who has dealt with Pat will speak of her sincere care. She approaches issues led not by the analytics expected of her professional background, but with a parent's concern about how a child will learn. And it is through this concern that her solutions emerge. The last thing you need to know about Pat is that she is loyal in what she believes in. She follows a solution tenaciously to its implementation. I've seen this in action. She will smile and listen patiently as you plead and present your case, but you know at the end of the day, she will continue to implement what she believes is right. And speaking of loyalty, I end by saying Pat Lagunda is loyal to Baliuag University. Just as she only had one boyfriend, who later on became her husband, she will only have one institution to care for, Baliuag. She doesn't need to search for quality because she has found it here. I started with a lighthearted condolence and I end with a serious note of congratulatory excitement for BU. Unlike many first-time presidents, myself included, Dr. Lagunda enters this job fully knowledgeable about both the challenges of higher education and its solutions. She knows senior high school, having been involved in its creation and structure. She knows ASEAN integration, having conducted seminars on the matter. She knows outcomes-based education, having brought her institution to being among its earliest adopters. Most importantly, for me at least, I think she knows how to deal with difficult personalities, having worked with so many university presidents. But most importantly, she knows Baliuag University, her heart and soul meshed with the people of this great place. Baliuag is fortunate to have her, and she to have BU. Congratulations, Pat, on your great achievement.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great honor and privilege to present formally the second president of the Baliuag University, who assumed the presidency in November of 2014. Equipped with a solid educational background, she finished her Bachelor of Arts in Economics at the University of the Philippines, where she was a university scholar. She earned her master's degree in business management at the Asian Institute of Management. She received her diploma for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy with distinction in Educational Leadership and Management from the De La Salle University. Dr. Lagunda, or Pat, joined Baliuag University in 1995 as Vice President for Administration and External Relations. She also taught at the School of Graduate Studies and Continuing Education, concomitant to her administrative work. Later, she was promoted to Executive Vice President, lending more focus to managing the school. Dr. Lagunda's experience in two fields provided her with what would eventually characterize her kind of leadership, the sophistication of business and the discipline of the academy. She has more than 18 years of educational leadership and management experience, representing both the university in regional, national, and international associations and organizations. Her involvement in civic and professional organizations, such as serving as president of the Zonda Club of Baliuag, part of a larger Zonda International Organization of Professional Empowering Women Worldwide. She became the president of the Philippine Association of Colleges and Universities, or PACU, from 2012 to 2014. In the same period, she served as chairman of the Coordinating Council of Private Educational Associations, or COCOPEA. Presently, she is a member of the Executive Committee and the Board of Trustees of the Philippine Retirement Annuity Association, or PERAA. In pursuit of innovation and progress, Dr. Lagunda has initiated programs, projects, and reforms in response to national and global developments. Together with the rest of Baliuag University family, and through her clear vision and her unique brand of leadership, Dr. Lagunda is committed to fulfilling her role in the history of Baliuag University and to making it a world-class educational institution, one that will endure into the next 90 years. On behalf of everyone in the university, let me present to you the second president of the Baliuag University, Dr. Patricia Bustos Lagunda.
The trustees of the Baliuag University repose complete trust and confidence in the integrity, fidelity, and ability of Patricia Bustos Lagunda of Baliuag, Bulacan. By virtue of the power vested on us, we do hereby appoint her second president of this university and the fourth president of this educational institution, and invest her with all the authority and power to execute and fulfill all the duties of the said office, according to the laws of the land and the charter of this noble institution, and in return, to have, exercise, and enjoy all the prerogatives and emoluments pertinent thereto. We further charge and impose on her the implementation and furtherance of the university's Declaration of Principles, its rules and regulations, and commitment to its founding mission for scholarship and quality education, service to the community, and strengthening of democratic institutions and the promotion of Christian character. Likewise, she is expected to uphold the university's academic vision of strengthening science and technology to propel our people towards global competitiveness and prosperity. Given in Baliuag, Bulacan, Philippines, under the corporate seal on this fifth day of August, in the year of our Lord 2015, and in the year of the institution, the 90th of its founding.
The university maze is a symbol of order and authority with an ancient history. Centuries ago, this emblem was a clubline, armor-breaking weapon of war. In medieval times, the mace borne by the king's sergeant-at-arms was associated with the protection of the king in France and England. In the 18th century, the mace began to be used for civil purposes and in processions of dignitaries. Eventually, the mace evolved into an emblem for academic institutions. In the 16th century, Oxford University began using a decorated mace in ceremonial processions to symbolize academic independence and excellence. Today, the mace still represents power, but it is the power of knowledge and the significance of university education. Ladies and gentlemen, Attorney Astea Santiago, representing the Chairman Dr. Alicia Santiago Bustos, Chairman of Baliuag University, and the Mace Bearer, Mr. Elvin R. Ventosilio, University Register, and Dr. Patricia B. Lagunda, incoming President of Baliuag University.
Patricia Bustos Lagunda, please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Patricia Bustos Lagunda,
Patricia Bustos Lagunda,
having been appointed, the second president of Baliuag University, do solemnly swear that I will discharge the duties of my office faithfully and to the best of my ability that I will observe with absolute fidelity the provision of laws governing private education in the Philippines that I will uphold and defend the charter of the corporation that I will obey and give due course to the resolutions and decisions on the general policy promulgated by the board of trustees that I will uphold
the mandate
and philosophy of the university
that I will remain faithful
to the lofty ideals
of the founder of the university
and that I impose these obligations
upon myself voluntarily
without mental reservation
or purpose of evasion
by this oath
I ask the help of the divine providence
with the intercession of Saint Augustine
the patron saint of the town of Baliuag
to bestow upon Baliuag University
and its constituents
his blessings
so that the institution
will realize its philosophy, vision, mission, and institutional goals.
So help me God.
Presidential Medallion is a symbol of authority, accomplishment, and distinction. The concept of this medallion started way back in biblical days as a sign of authority. In the Middle Ages, the medallion signified membership in religious orders and guilds. Eventually, it has become customary for medallions to be bestowed on chancellors and presidents of universities. Today, the medallion we will present is symbolic not only of the office of the president, but also of the history, achievements, and maturity of Baliuag University in its role within the community and society. Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medallion, please welcome once again Attorney Astea Santiago with Dr. Norman S. Bustos, Member, Board of Trustees.
our Honorable Chair, Dr. Patricia B. Licuanan, to our beloved Mayor of Baliuag, Mayor Carol De Liosa, distinguished guests, members of the Baliuag University community, friends, relatives, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Today's event, although formally called an investiture, celebrates more than the installation of a new university president. It holds much great significance and meaning, for in essence, what we celebrate and honor is this educational institution, ang Pamantasang Baliuag, its life and times through its 90 years, as well as the very people who give life to the university, its faculty, staff, students, alumni, and the community. Today is a perfect time to reflect on how far BU has come and to look forward to a promising future that lies ahead. When the late Domingo B. Santiago Sr., whom we lovingly call Tatang, founded the Baliuag Institute, a small high school with a total enrollment of 75 students in 1925, together with his educator wife and our Ima, Consuelo Alejo Santiago, he had a vision for the school to become an instrument of change in the lives of the youth and their families within our service area through quality education, a vision that echoed from this small town to other parts of the Bulacan province and beyond. Years later, the institute evolved and became the Baliuag Junior College when it started to offer a few baccalaureate courses. Some years after, Baliuag Colleges came to be before finally becoming, in 2001, the Baliuag University, a higher education institution that today is one of only 42 autonomous private HEIs in the country, and offering programs from preschool to postgraduate levels. I wonder what Tatang and Ima would make of the school today. It has certainly come to be so much more than what he had started all those years ago. And yet, at the end of the day, we have lived up to Tatang's founding vision. We have stayed true to our vision, mission, and guiding philosophy to make BU one of the most respected, innovative, and leading academic institutions in Region 3. What Baliuag University is today is due in large part to the efforts and initiatives of my predecessor, Dr. Alicia Santiago Bustos, and her brother, the late Attorney Domingo Santiago Jr. or Dico, as he is known to many. On the occasion of her investiture as the university's first president in 2001, Dr. Bustos made a promise, and I quote, "We in Baliuag University are prepared not to just passively react and respond to the developments from above and beyond, but to become a strong influence in forcing ourselves to help shape and reshape these developments. We don't intend to merely survive. We will excel. We shall find our respective niche and become the best in whatever we decide and know we do best." Unquote. Dr. Bustos led the university to reach greater heights, even beyond the bar that she had set. She rallied faculty and staff, as well as alumni, to contribute to the efforts to make BU a competitive HEI committed to students' intellectual, cultural, and economic growth and development, and enhancing and influencing the communities it serves. Many of you here may be well aware that growing up, I never saw myself becoming an educator, more so a university president. It was because of filial piety, or by default, so to speak, that I decided to join the school and become an academic way back in 1995.
At this point, I would like to thank and acknowledge the individuals who have supported and guided me. I stand before you today as the second president of this university, on the shoulders of these people who have played a major role in my personal and professional journey. To my husband, Engineer Ali Lagunda, my daughters Janina and Janelle, son Nicolo, my siblings Norman, Susan, Nina, Alice, and Jesse, and their spouses, and my not-so-little anymore nieces and nephews, who have been my support system from day one, my heartfelt gratitude and love. To the members of the Board of Trustees of BU, individuals who are just as passionate and committed to this institution and its stakeholders, I would like to thank them for their careful advice and for having confidence in me to be president. To our esteemed officials from government, thank you for gracing this momentous event and showing your support to partners in the private sector. I wish to acknowledge the presence of all the college and university presidents and administrators who are here now, coming from educational institutions outside of BU. They remind us that BU is part of something greater than itself, a circle of higher education institutions equally committed to their respective schools and to the improvement of overall education in the Philippines. I am so pleased and honored to see colleagues from Kokopeya, Paku, Peraa, Papsku, Pakokoa, friends from Zonta, College of the Holy Spirit, UP, AIM, former classmates from DLSU, and my partners from Staff Consulting Group, and to my relatives and kin from the Alejo, Santiago, Bustos, and Lagunda clan. Also here today are the administrators, academic heads, and faculty members of Baliuag University, the nuts and bolts that make this university work. Aside from their work and teaching, their passion and commitment to serve our students, the community, and the university have contributed to what BU is today and will be in the years to come. I would like to acknowledge as well the hardworking and caring staff members and non-teaching personnel of BU who attend to the many needs of everyone, from the administration to our students, parents, and visitors. Students represented by their students and organization leaders, alumni, academic and industry partners who are as much part of the BU family as those who work for it. My sincerest thanks for your commitment and trust in the university. You too play a vital role in making the Baliuag University the best it can be. To Tatang, who relentlessly trailblazed paths to bring quality education to this humble town, thank you for inspiring us to continue your legacy. And to Dico, who exhorted the value of building personal relations with the school's constituents and various publics, and who showed us how to be forward thinkers, you will always be missed. Last but surely not the least, my mom, our mom, and my predecessor, Dr. Ali Santiago Bustos. Her indomitable spirit and admirable leadership as an academic administrator is something I look up to even today. I can only hope to be as good an educator and as charming as her. I think I speak for everyone when I say that we are grateful for her wisdom and courage, as well as her generosity with her knowledge, and for affecting us with her commitment to our beloved BU. I owe it to these people and to the glorious past, ang maringal na kahapon of this university, to lead it to a radiant future o maningning na bukas. As we are all aware, the ASEAN integration is upon us. For our part in the education sector, one fundamental question is, how prepared is the Philippine higher education sector for ASEAN 2015? Internally, we at BU must also ask ourselves, how ready is BU for this integration?
Some scientists maintain that readiness is measured in terms of competitiveness, where HEIs in the Philippines, such as BU, must have the potential to be institutions of choice for foreign students. Another challenge to school administrators and leaders is the K-12 program, which in its thrust to nurture holistically developed Filipino youth, has made schools and universities redefine their direction. This radical reform means we have to ensure that our graduates are college and livelihood ready, equipped with 21st century skills in information, media and technology, learning and innovation, effective communication, and life and career. Within this context, and in consideration of our centennial celebration, we at BU need to keep up with the times and even stand out. Happily, we have always been up to the task. Hence, we will make every effort to attain some very specific goals and targets within the next 10 years. The university will endeavor to develop new and attractive academic programs, responsive and relevant to current and emerging national, regional, and global development goals. Alongside this, we will critically evaluate our curriculum to ensure that it is vibrant, up-to-date, creative, and technologically adapted to the 21st century. As we endeavor to bring in, develop, and maintain high-caliber, competent, and value-laden faculty, so too do we work hard towards their professional development. In line with this, we will identify areas of strategic importance so that new and existing faculty members will impact not just one department, but bring together students and faculty across disciplines in innovative programs in the sciences, education, business, humanities, and the arts. This is interdisciplinarity at its best. We will ensure that every department will grow and that every student and every member of the faculty and staff will benefit. We must also prepare for continued enrollment growth, both at the undergraduate and graduate levels. After the lull in freshman and college enrollment due to the forthcoming senior high school implementation and the demographic increase of college-age students, there is a promise of a wave of applicants in the near future. We can expect the demand for graduate programs to grow as professions have become more complex these days, and businesses and other institutions are seeking more individuals with graduate degrees. As such, affordable graduate education is a promise we make to the people of Baliuag and beyond. As we aim to increase the number of our faculty members and student population, we must invest in our relevant infrastructure. BU today is the only university in the region with a green building. We will continue to improve our physical facilities. We have other buildings that are up for modernization to better serve the needs of the university, especially those that have been the setting of countless memories of students and staff, past and present. We will also strengthen national and international linkages for research activities and student academic exchange programs. We will embrace the culture of scholarship more, our faculty, staff, and students being actively engaged in research work, presentation, and publication to gain recognition locally and internationally. Moreover, we will reinforce our linkage with industry partners and workplace executives with whom we can engage in curricular reforms. We will pursue and broaden our internationalization efforts in the areas of curriculum, faculty and student exchange, research and education partnerships. In this interconnected world, we need to accommodate international perspectives and dimensions. We will continue to place premium on the importance of quality assurance like accreditation and other QA mechanisms. We believe that external assessment is an integral part of institutional and program development. We will establish and practice our corporate social responsibility, which is a significant as our commitment to improving the lives of people within our service area. Our community outreach programs and research should be relevant and aid in addressing current issues like climate change adaptation and disaster risk, and help in sustainable development of our locality. We will keep the tradition that has made BU education competitive. We shall focus on giving deserving and underprivileged students access to all that higher education has to offer through our various programs, notably our Binhi and Gintong Ani scholarship programs. We will strengthen our ties with alumni who at some point in their lives had made BU their home. We need to create and maintain alumni chapters from all over for a more inclusive and expanded membership who can contribute to the BU community. That said, I stand before you today proud and humbled to be the second president of Baliuag University. We stand for what is best about private education, that is to be a home for research and innovation, a place for learning and scholarship, a center for creative arts, a pathway for social mobility for diverse students, and a partner of our stakeholders as well as communities. We will continue to achieve excellence by working together. As I speak of the future that I envision for our beloved university, I cannot avoid but be overconfident about the horizon that looms large before us. The mission we have put upon ourselves may be made difficult by the political and social environment, particularly the challenges of K-12 and ASEAN integration. But our aspirations for a bolder, bigger, and stronger Baliuag University can only be tempered with as much realistic capacity we can rely on. Hurdling the immediate future is perhaps the most daunting and common concern among private educators. Maybe I speak in behalf of all my colleagues in private education that we have our fears and are treading lightly with our respective schools amidst the major reforms in the transitioning education landscape. Be that as it may, I am standing by my conviction that we will see a radiant future, a maningning na bukas for Baliuag University. The path to uncertainty may eventually lead to unexpected opportunities. I ask each of you to join me in our mission of making universities, such as the Baliuag University, as instrument for the most radiant future it can be. Today is and will be the beginning of our journey towards 100 years. May God bless our Baliuag University. Sa inyo pong lahat, maraming salamat.
This has been a historical event for Baliuag University. We would like to thank our distinguished guests and to everyone who is present here today for gracing this occasion. Please remain standing for the exit of the colors. Ladies and gentlemen, a sumptuous feast awaits us at the courtyard of the main campus. Magandang tanghali at mabuhay ang Baliuag University! Mga kaibigan, ang Baliuag University Band para sa marcha ng pamantasang Baliuag.
drunk but was sober. Is it true that you love me? I dare you to kiss me with a